I was leaving school one day with a bunch of my friends. We were getting off the bus to go to one of my friends' house. We get a knock at the door, and it was the gang unit. And they were demanding to come into the house, saying that he's violating his probation by having all of these gang members over. Most of us weren't in the gangs. We were just coming from school. They was like, y'all can't leave just yet. I need y'all to go to the side of the house and we're gonna take a group photo. I was pretty much the only one who didn't wanna abide. And I said, this is illegal, you can't do this, you're not supposed to do this to us, we're only minors. And the first thing he says to me is, if you don't take a picture, your friend to the left is just gonna go to jail. And at the moment, I felt like I had no choice, so I just took a picture with them. From then on, they told us we're now guilty by association. I wanted to make sure this didn't happen again, and especially to people that didn't deserve it.
There have been conflicts with the police, and there's perpetuating violence in our communities where there has to be something, we have to do something about it instead of letting it continue on.
Law enforcement came together and came to an agreement on a bill, and that bill is the one that has that passed the Senate for the last 2 years and finally passed the House this year and has been signed into law. But a lot of what has been discussed as important to the community over the years has been left by the wayside.
It was originally a state bill about, you know, police accountability and protecting communities of color. That bill, however, got co-opted and watered down, and it wasn't what people wanted originally. And so, you know, PRISM, Owning the Bill, Neighborhood Association, DARE, Direct Action for Rights and Equality, and the American Friends Society came together and like, okay, you know, we need to make our own bill.
It has 12 provisions in it that go from video recording by police, video recording by the people, all the way to immigration, language access.
Veto it, and if he does, then you need to have 10 council people approve it. So right now we're working on getting those 10 numbers.
Right now we're just planning to outreach as much as possible before we have another community meeting with the city council, and we believe that at this moment the CSA wouldn't be passed. Some barriers that would be in the way of the Community Safety Act would be the people's wards in the east side. Not only because they are white, but because they are mostly associated with the police.
Everything proposed in the Community Safety Act were concerns that were brought up by the community itself. The organizations that helped put it together didn't just go to a drawing board and say this, and that needs to be in there. There were actually members of the community that were concerned about police accountability within neighborhoods that were targeted specifically by police. The people that are targeted by these policies that are created within the city and the state are people of low income and people of color. We don't have the resources available to combat these things, you know? So we have to build a sort of culture of resistance against mass incarceration, racial profiling, police brutality.
And our job is not even remotely done. This is a very small part of a very large problem, and now is the time to work together to build upon that and not just ignore it until a new problem comes up.
Because if this bill is passed, they'll be the first in the country that kind of has that explicit accountability happening, and it can set, you know, it can set an example that, you know, communities, you actually can make a difference. You actually can make your police accountable. You can, your voice matters, and this bill is a way of showing that.